Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's look at how to create Finder quick actions using Automator. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about it, join us, and get exclusive content. So quick actions allow you to select a file and perform an action on them right in the Finder. Now, there's some that you get built in with macOS Mojave, but you can also create your own using Automator. Let's look at two examples. So if you're not familiar with quick actions, you see them in the Finder. You select a file and in the preview area here on the right, you'll see them at the bottom. If you don't see a preview area here, you can go to View and then Show and Hide Preview right here. Now notice I have a video selected, so I have Trim and Rotate Left quick actions. If I select another type of file like an image, I'll get different ones like Markup, Create PDF. And other ones I may not get any quick action. A Pages document gives me nothing. I could always click on More here and Customize, and I can change which quick actions will show up here in the Finder. So I have four that are selected here. So let's go and create one that is a custom one. These are all defaults except this watermark one here, which I created for a previous tutorial. As a simple example, let's create something that will create a backup of a file before you work on it. Say you have a graphics document and you want to make some changes, but you want to save a copy somewhere before you start messing with it. So we'll use Automator to create a quick action here. You see one of the options you get when you create a new document in Automator is quick action. So you want to select that, go to choose. Now we can set up some things for the workflow. Workflow receives the current what? So we want to say files or folders. Then we'll say not in any application, but in the Finder. This is going to be a Finder quick action. Now we can start to add actions to the workflow here. So we're going to want to copy this file. So we can use copy. We can search here and say, yeah, there's copy Finder items. A better thing might be there's an archive one, create an archive. So this will compress the file, which will be useful because the idea is here we're just creating a backup copy and we're probably not going to use it. It'd be nice to actually make that a little bit smaller in case we do this a lot. So create an archive, same name as input, to leave save as empty. Now we want to create a place for this to go. So we'll select other. We'll go to the documents folder and create a archived backups folder there. And this is where we'll keep all of these things. And that's it. It will just do that. So let's save now. And the first time we save, it's going to ask us for a name. So let's call this Backup Archive. And we'll hit Save. Now we'll hide Automator. We don't need to close this just yet. And we can select a file, Test Numbers Document here. And you can see we get Backup Archive now there. Now the reason it appears there is because there was no other quick action there, so it immediately jumped on it and said, well, I might as well fill that in there. If we didn't see it or if we saw other things there, like for instance, if I went to this video, I'm still going to see Trim and Rotate Left, but I could hit this three dots button here and you can see Backup Archive appears. I could also go to Customize and I could see these here and I could drag Backup Archive to the top so it takes precedence over these other ones. Now you see it appear there. So let's go and do a backup archive of test.numbers. I'll click this and it runs. You can see the gear appeared really quickly at the top there. Let's create a new Finder window. And in the new Finder window, I'll look for that folder in my documents folder here. The folder's called Archived Backups, and there is that zipped file there, which has that inside of it. And we can look at it here and see, oh, it's 73K, which is actually smaller than the 109K, so it compressed it for us really nicely. Now any file we want to go and work on, say this Pages document here, we can click on it, hit Backup Archive real quick, and then we can know that it's been saved, a copy's been saved into that folder. So kind of a useful little quick action there, because I know a lot of people that like to duplicate a file before they work on it. So let's look at another example, because you could do so many things with Automator here. I'm going to close this document there and I'm going to create a new quick action. And what I'm going to do with this one is I want to be able to read in text files. So I'll select Documents in Finder And what it's going to do is it's going to get the contents of that document and speak them. So I could just search for speak here, and there's speak text. And you think if I put that there, now it will speak the text in the voice that I choose. So let's save this. We'll call it speak text file. And hit save. And now we'll hide Automator there, select the text file, and it's not going to perform as we expect. If I use this, I'm going to hear the name of the file.
Users MACMOST documents testdocs text file.txt.
Actually, the full path even. So what it's clearly doing is in Automator here gets the document and then it speaks the path to the document. So how do we get it to speak the text inside the document? So this is where we can expand our Automator action using some scripting. So you can do shell scripting, you can do Apple script. I'm going to use JavaScript or JXA as the more modern way of doing it. We're going to create a quick JXA script that's going to get the contents of the file and then pass that to speak text. So I'll search here for JavaScript and select run JavaScript. I'll put that there and I can put my script right here. So the script is fairly simple. So I've just pasted it in. It sets a variable app equal to the current application because JavaScript needs to perform actions using the application that's running. In this case it's going to be the finder. And then it uses app.includeStandardEditions equals true. You need to do that in order to basically perform actions on that app. Then it's going to get output equal to app.read, which will read the contents of input. Input in this case is going to be the document passed in. Then it's just going to return that output. So output should be getting the text because it's a text file and then returning the text. And then that goes into the speak text action. So it should speak the text that's inside the document. Let me switch over to the finder and I have the text file selected. I'll use speak text file which appears right here for it.
This is a text edit text document.
So it works. Now note that this works with a text document because the contents are text. If I select something else it may not work. For instance, this RTF document. RTF is rich text format. It contains all sorts of odd formatting and things. So if it tries to speak this, you'll get a whole jumble of stuff.
RTF 1 ANSI ANSI 1252 COCORD 1000 SWISF CHARS.
So I could stop that here using this little gear in the menu bar. And you definitely don't want to try to have it speak the contents of a image or a video. Purely for text documents. There's so much more you can do with quick actions. You can build all sorts of workflows inside of Automator and as I showed you can use JavaScript or Apple script or even shell scripts in Automator to do even more with files if you know how. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.